Thank you so much. Welcome to Boxley's. We're excited to be here. I have on bass the amazing Phil Sparks. And from Seattle, no, from New York, from, no, from New, Seattle and New York, the incredible Bob Meyer. Bob lives in New York. He's played with a bunch of schmucks there, like Joe Lovano and John Abercrombie and about a million others from the Jazz Hall of Fame. So we're very fortunate that he has a son out here and comes out to visit. And so when I knew he would be coming out, I got us this gig just so we'd have an opportunity to hear his talents. So that was a tune by Artie Shaw called Moonray. We're gonna go on. Boy, this is an eclectic bunch of music you're gonna hear tonight, just from the four corners of jazz. We're gonna play a Chick Corea tune for you now called Humpty Dumpty. Thank you. Okay, when Bob was out here, living here, he played a lot with an incredible saxophonist by the name of Bert Wilson, who I think we lost 10 years ago. Is that right?
10 years ago.
Bert Wilson, he was in Olympia, and was actually a real giant of the instrument and an incredible composer. Yeah, and also a fan of John Coltrane. He liked to write a lot of tunes based on John Coltrane's tune Giant Steps. But right now we're going to do a much more mellow tune of his, appropriate for this time of night. It's called Dusk. Thank you. you. That was Dusk. We're going to do down in Olympia in about 8 days a whole concert of Bert Wilson's music. So I've been learning a lot of his music lately. We're going to do another one of his tunes now. I mentioned he was a fan of John Coltrane, and this is a tune based on Coltrane's tune Giant Steps. It's kind of Giant Steps backwards, at least for part of it, and it's called Forward Motion.
Thank you.
It was almost a year ago that I was here in August of 2022. And my bass player that night was a kind of a giant of Northwest jazz by the name of Chuck Dierdorf. I taught at Cornish for Cornish College of the Arts for 41 years, and he was there the entire time. So we were in the trenches together. We had many lunches, many faculty meetings, lots of jokes, a lot of good times, shared many, many bandstands apart from our collaborations at Cornish. He passed in October of COVID. I was on a cruise in Europe at the time, and we were just coming into port in Gibraltar when I learned that he was gone. So when I got home, I wrote a tune for him, and that eventually became a suite. First tune is called Gibraltar, and this is the Gibraltar Suite, and this is for Chuck Dierdorf. Thank you. So that's Gibraltar. Originally, I just wrote that one tune, and then, as I say, it expanded into three tunes. The next tune I wrote had a kind of a bell-like quality to it, or chimes. And also, I thought that to do Chuck and his wife, Kelly, had just an unbelievably storybook romance. I don't know, married for 40 years or whatever, but they were newlyweds the entire time. And her nickname was Kel. So it kind of came as a natural title. We're going to play for you now, Kel's Bells. Kells Bells. We have one more part to this suite. I figure if Chuck had his tune and Kel had her tune, their son should have a tune. Chuck was a very, had a very low-key manner to him. He was just very cool, never broke a sweat. He really enjoyed a good joke, but his kind of steady state was just very low-key. But he could get animated, and one time when he was always counted on getting animated was whenever he spoke about his son, because he was so proud of this kid who is now a young man. So he would be very animated and upbeat, and Will was very animated and is very upbeat all the time. So this is a very animated and upbeat tune. I struggled mightily with the title, and I finally came up with Will. Thank you. you so much. That's for Chuck Dierdorf. That's the Gibraltar Suite. Let's have a hand for Bob Meyer on the drums. That is the first time he's ever played that suite. And Phil Sparks on the bass. And I'm Randy Halberstadt. I neglected to mention that earlier. We've enjoyed playing for you. We're going to take a little break. We'll be back in about 20 minutes and do another set for you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. second set here.
I said, welcome back. We're doing our second set here. We enjoyed the first one. I hope you did. And who are we? We are Phil Sparks on the bass. And from Seattle, New York, Seattle, back to New York, and now in Seattle visiting, Bob Meyer on drums. My name is Randy Halberstadt. Thank you. There was a Polish composer by the name of Bronisław Kiper. Wrote some legit music. And was discovered in Vienna by Louis Mayer of MGM Productions, brought to Hollywood where he did some film scores. And he wrote this tune that we're gonna do, although I should tell you the name of it. Even if you know this tune, it's highly disguised. So this is my highly disguised arrangement of On Green Dolphin Street. Thank you. Port Townsend, a wonderful festival that happens coincidentally in Port Townsend. Actually, it doesn't. It occurs in Fort Worden, about 2 miles outside of town. And every year, other than last year, we have a wonderful pianist, part of jazz history, played with Freddie Hubbard, played with Dexter Gordon, wonderful, played with Bob Meyer by the name of George Cables. He's there every year, and he's a wonderful pianist and also a great composer. We're going to do a tune of his now called Looking for the Light.
I'm going to play the whole tune by myself. Thank you.
That's a pretty tune. Yeah, I wish I'd written that. We did a couple Burt Wilson tunes on the last set. We're going to do a couple more for you. This first one, it's not quite as formidable as the title might suggest. It's called Onslaught. Kind of a bebop tune. Burt Wilson was nothing if not broad in his stylistic capabilities. I was telling Bob on the way here of a gig, because left to his own resources, Burt would tend to play what many people would consider maybe avant-garde, but at least very, very sometimes strident and a lot of high squeaks and, you know. But he sat in on a gig that I was playing with a really conservative, very, very good bebop player, old school, and they didn't know each other. The alto player's name was Lanny Morgan, and Lanny stylistically was here, and Burt was here in terms of what I'd heard him do. But when they got together on Lanny's gig, Lanny moved his style like this much, and Burt moved all the way over here. He said, okay, this is what's happening tonight. This is this guy's gig, and I'm going to make some good music with him. So I was highly impressed at how versatile Burt was. So this is kind of the more bebop side of Burt, called Onslaught.
Thank you.
Okay, so maybe it is as formidable as the title suggests. It's Onslaught. Except it's not as formidable as the next one. We're going to do another Bert Wilson tune for you now. This one is... This one's kind of scary. It's called Outside Moves by Bert Wilson. tune for Halloween. That's scary. Oh, we are going to close off with a definite contrast to that. This is by a pianist named Enrico Pieronunzi. This is a tune to send you floating out on a cloud. This is a much, it's got some beautiful harmonies on. Enrico Pieronunzi he's still around. He lives in Milan, and he was one of Chet Baker's last pianists. So we're going to close off with this tune called Don't Forget the Poet. But before we do that, another hand for Phil Sparks on the bass. Yes, yeah. And Bob Meyer on drums. Okay. Thank you. Don't forget the poet. On your drive home, don't forget the poet. Phil Sparks on bass, Bob Meyer on drums. I'm Randy Halberstadt. Thank you so much. You've been a great audience.